they go low, you go high. You stay high. 420. Blaze it. This is me, Nick Potter, endorsing the use of marijuana in all 50 states. That's my catchphrase. Whoa.
Wow.
Welcome to Very Real Talk, everybody.
Is you saying that's my catchphrase part of the catchphrase?
Yes, that was the whole catchphrase. Everything I say before Welcome to Very Real Talk is the catchphrase, just so you know, for in the future.
It's a bumper sticker, but only for buses.
Yep, that's the only place it can fit. My name is Nick Potter, the host of this Very Real podcast. I got some boys with me, as per usual. I'm going to start with my good friend Colin Sage. E. Colin, question for you.
Yes.
What's your ideal date look like?
Ooh.
What do you want the ladies to do when you go out on a date? What do they want them to do for you?
Whoa. What do I want them to do for me? Yeah. Well, let's start off first. My ideal date obviously involves a Waffle House.
Perfect. You know,
whether or not it's before,
yeah, I was
going to
say, is that step one, step three, or step eight?
Even if it's at the end,
yeah.
After the date's over and she's gone, it's in there.
Yeah.
It's good.
You can just reflect on your date with all the Waffle House staff.
Right. You know, any date, it depends on the person.
Sure.
Obviously, movies is not a date. I don't understand why people still do that because you're not talking to each other.
Right.
You're just staring emptily at the next Marvel movie.
Well, that's more of an excuse just to... For the next 2 hours, you can be close to me.
Yeah, you
and not
can be
worry
in my
about
vicinity,
it.
And I'll be able to tell people that that
nice.
Happened.
Right. Yeah, it's like a mental Waffle House, if you will.
Sure.
Yeah, so I think you want something, maybe a little bit of activity, maybe a little bit of food,
right?
Maybe a little bit of beverage.
Yes. And a little activity.
And then,
nope.
Yeah. And definitely.
Yeah, definitely that last thing.
Definitely that last thing.
For sure.
Waffle House.
All right. The other person here. His name is Joey Potter. He's my brother.
Chip.
Joey, what's your favorite dating app? What are you on lately?
Steam.
In the comment section, just trolling for dates.
Yeah, I just, I get on Steam and I just go down the list and I swipe on it on my tablet.
Yeah.
It doesn't do anything.
Right.
But mentally, I'm like, yes,
nice.
No. No Train Simulator 2022.
Yeah.
Get that out of here.
You leave a review, you're like, the Witcher 3 is really tight. But anyway, who's trying to go out tonight?
Yeah, I do that. And then I have Omegle. Is that still a thing?
Yeah, I think so. I think that website still exists.
Yeah, and then I just, look at dudes jacking off.
Perf.
Is that what that is?
Is that part of your ideal date as well?
I'm thinking that Omegle, right? Where you...
I don't
like
I don't
match
know
up with random webcams.
Yeah, Omegle's one of Omegle? It's like chat roulette.
Chat roulette, that's what I was thinking.
It's the same
of.
Thing, I think, where you just
is
randomly
really?
Match with people. Oh. Yeah.
Yeah, chat roulette. And it's mostly just dudes like sadly beating off.
Hoping that gets
as
them a date.
To
they're like, is anybody interested in this?
I skipped right to the eighth step.
We can go watch Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness together.
And then the saddest part of all, they bring out a bag of Waffle House pickup to go. And you're like, oh, that shit doesn't last, bro.
Yeah, you can't get that stuff to go. Oh. No way.
Well, you want to be careful when you're on Omegle or Chat Roulette, because if you're jacking off as well, and then you get another guy jacking off, and your dicks lock eyes... You don't want to know what happens.
You both get petrified Medusa style. Turn to stone.
Just stand there forever.
Yep. You're locked in Omegle or Chat Roulette forever.
A bunch of folks just walking. Hey, what happened? They turn into stone too. Now there's a huge queue of stone people.
Yeah.
That's why they're going to shut that site down.
Sooner or later.
And that third voice you're hearing is our guest this week. It's Corey Music. He's back in the studio.
Back again.
Corey, I'm going to ask you a question. It's going to be the same exact question because Joey gave me a bullshit answer. What apps are you using?
I don't use dating. I was so thankful you asked Joey and not me. I don't really use them. I'm like a dad when it comes to this stuff, man. I've never used a dating app sincerely.
Okay.
And I mean that.
Yeah, okay.
My dating app is the world, is opportunity, whoa. Is the sky, is the horizon, my friend. It's
the air we breathe.
Exactly.
All right, well, can I ask him a question then?
Yes.
Corey, what that dick do?
Okay, that's why you don't get to ask questions anymore.
So are you on Omegle then? Is that
what... Yeah, I'm trying to lock eyes.
I don't want to turn to stone, man.
Yeah, I want Corey and you to live.
I have too much to live for with my dick.
Yeah.
Hey, exactly. Man, that's the roulette, you know?
I'm so...
Is that what that is?
Yeah, yeah, it's literally pointing a gun to your fucking head, man.
You've got a six-shooter revolver. Two of those slots are filled with penis.
Yep.
What's going to happen when you pull that trigger?
I'm really lucky. I got with my wife before the dating app scene blew up. I never had to use Tinder, Bumble, Christian chat roulette, whatever it is.
Oh, nice. Farmers only?
Farmersonly.com. Yeah. I never had to get it. I assume there's one for like goth kids to like hook up.
I thought you said vets. Like
I was going to say vampire kids, okay. But that's not really a thing as much as maybe emo. I don't know. Are they over too?
You're thinking of Vampire Freaks, that one website from middle school that I perused.
We were trolling for dates on Vampire Freaks. Why not?
Oh, okay.
Did any of you guys troll for dates on AOL back when, or AIM, getting those chat rooms?
I mean, there was no way I was getting a date because I was a 22 female from Florida.
ASL, man.
On those Yahoo chats, I definitely would look and see who had webcams.
Yeah?
And I got chat roulette several times. Okay. Like, before that existed, I was like, oh, it's a lady's name. Cool. Like, oh, you can get into their webcam? Tight. I'm 12. And then it's just a grown man jerking off. Yep. And I was like, I don't like the internet anymore.
Yeah. I learned something important.
My dial-up connection. Shut this off.
Do you think everyone who does that thinks like they have the most brilliant idea ever? Like, oh, I can't. I got this webcam. Just wait to see what happens next. But everyone's doing the same thing. It's crazy.
Right. We've talked about that before. Everyone in the lesbian chat room on AIM was all. All like 12-year-old boys.
Yeah.
Like, they really have their own chat room somewhere else. And, like, what do we think was going to be happening in those lesbian chat rooms? Like, dude.
Early 2000s media told us it would be pillow fights, some kind of cool music.
You're right.
Yeah.
Or, like, a KY Jelly wrestling match. Yep. Old school, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
You know? We got tainted. Tainted by the media.
Yeah.
Tell you about another cesspool of the internet for a short amount of time.
Tight.
Uno on the Xbox 360.
What
because
is that?
You could Uno, the
like,
game.
Oh,
Uno,
the card game? Oh,
the
no.
card game Uno on Xbox
Uno's
360.
Uno's become vilified.
Because Xbox came out with that camera and you could do a webcam. Like you could basically live stream on Uno. So it'd be four people in a like around an Uno table with just pictures. And then my buddy, not gonna name names, would jerk off. But like in like a fun, like he'd be like just like mooning the camera or just like, you know, just being ridiculous. It wasn't like he was more just like putting his dick out there for goofs than like malicious intent.
Right.
Because he was also 15.
Ooh. Oh, so- no!
Oh. He buried the lead there.
The people who come up with these things, like, we'll use a camera for Uno, like, are they just, like, the most naive newborn babies that have ever walked the earth that, like, think that people won't use that stuff to put their genitals on it? Like, it's all... Or is that just the thing that they know is going to happen, but they're trying to do something good instead? Like, we know that some jokesters are going to be putting their genitalia out there, but we really want people to see each other when they're playing Uno. It's part of the experience.
We have it in the terms of service that you can't do that.
They have a big board with the graphs. They have the big graph board, and it's like number of genitals projected. And it's like, but like, you know, like grandmas who get to spend time with their family, like, they're like, the numbers aren't looking good, Johnson, but let's just roll the dice. It's Uno.
Yep. Yeah, maybe humanity's changed somehow for the better.
That was also a big problem in the early days of the PS4, like, because it came with the camera and it had like the playroom or something. Or it was like its own. Like walled garden Twitch or something. I can't fully remember, but yeah, that was just cam show galore.
Oof,
yeah.
Can anyone ever use a camera without that without that result? Is there some scientist out there
who
can
also
figure
wants
it out?
Yeah. Sorry, but who also wants to sit you with like Cheetos on your shirt, just leaning back in your couch like playing a game? That's not interesting.
Right.
Why?
Jerking off is interesting.
Yes,
I'll give you
that's
that.
More interesting.
If anything, you know, it's at least a little action.
You know, people say that the dark web is a dangerous place, but I think the regular web is a dangerous place anyway. Like,
dark web,
terrifying.
You can buy drugs, you can like get an assassin. No one jerking off on the dark web, just saying.
Nope.
Right.
It's true.
Too dark to see.
Yeah, they're buying people to come jerk them off.
Yeah, at any moment, your dick could lock eyes with another dick, and then it's over.
Yep, you just got Medusa'd.
Yeah, you got dicks selling cocaine on the dark web, you know? they're not beating off.
Yeah. All right, let's just stop this conversation dead in its tracks and move on to our topic this week. Guys, I'm looking around this room right now. And I'm seeing just a bunch of, like, really good-looking guys.
Wow, thanks, man.
Like, three hunky dudes. I can't see myself. I know I'm a hunky dude, but I see you guys, and I know for a fact, I know that the opposite gender is interested in all of you. And Joey, I know that we've gone on dates before.
Joey's making a face with his pizza pants.
Hey, some girls like pizza pants, you know what I'm saying?
Got my podcast pajamas on.
Yep.
You in my house.
That's, yeah, when he brings a girl over, he's just like, sorry, I'm getting into my pizza pants.
He just throws
and like, what does that mean? And then he does it, and like, oh, okay. He meant exactly what you said.
He throws Uno down on the table, and he's like, you know what
He turns his webcam on, puts his pizza pants on.
I hand her a laptop. Yeah. I make her go in the other room. Yeah.
And then you play Counter-Strike. Perfect. Yeah.
This episode is really just a chance to show how masculine and cool we are. We've all been on dates, right? Mm-hmm. We're getting really toxic right now, okay? We all go on dates with girls, okay? We're manly. Society accept us. You already accepted me. I'm married, okay? You guys, though, not so married right now.
Not so married, no.
Not so,
but
15%
on
the married.
You know, we've all gone on dates. I thought we'd talk about the worst date that we've ever gone on.
Oh, man.
Hmm.
As the four of us, like, what's the worst friend date that we've gone on? Doing this podcast, maybe?
Yeah, I don't know.
The one where Colin talked about his colon rock. That was a bad date for me.
That was.
The one where we did a podcast at midnight and Joey's got drunk and started screaming that'll suck our dicks.
Yeah.
Comedy.
Yeah, what are you going to do?
Comedy.
That's Corey's our lawyer. Our excuse for everything we say on this podcast, it's comedy.
Yeah, that's not going to work, but...
Oh. Damn it, why are we doing this then?
It's parody.
We already talked about he has no power here. No.
That's true, he's in Indiana. He lost his suit fell apart on the way over.
That's right.
I keep buying these. Why do I keep bringing the suits?
I don't know. Keep buying $600
suits. It'll change this time.
Yeah.
It'll be different. You'll see. I bought the suit in Indiana, but as soon as I put it on, it still falls apart.
Can I have my money back? And they're like, no, it just turned to ash. You absolutely cannot have your money back. Are you a lawyer in a different state, sir? Why would you even do that?
I have to go now.
In fact, we're suing you.
No!
No! It's a lawyer's worst nightmare!
Speaking of bad nightmares, though...
Mm-hmm. Guys, who wants to start and tell me, and therefore the rest of us, therefore our audience... about the worst date they've ever been on. I'll start. Here we go.
I'm very excited. Me and Nick have a long, quiet, very tumultuous car ride over here, and he refused to tell me what his worst date is.
Yeah. I wanted to save it.
I've been ready.
I want your live, real reaction. I don't want you faking it. Like, whoa, what,
right.
Nick? That's
I'm
hilarious.
Just sitting in the passenger seat, just shuffling my Uno cards, just waiting.
Yep. He's like, Nick, can you turn on the interior lights? No one can see me on my Uno chat.
Can you turn on the interior webcam? I put a webcam in your glove box, by the way.
All right, perfect. Thank you.
It is kind of perfect.
Yeah. Okay, so my worst date that I've ever been on, it was about 2 years before I met my wife. I was in college, and I met this girl, I don't even remember, through friends somehow, and obviously not going to say her name.
But are we going to say her name?
No, you guys don't know her. I thought that she, at the time, was out of my league. It turns out that was true, but I was the one that was above her.
Oh.
Nice. Surprise twist for me, too, guys. I thought she was better than me. Turns out I was better than her.
Halfway through the date, did you just stand up and said, oh, I'm better than you, and you left?
Wait, I had that thought.
You're the garbage person? What the fuck?
Wow, I showed up in pizza pants.
You have to be a really shitty person to be able to be worse than that. And she was. Here we go. So, first of all, the first part is my fault. Because I always do my movie research. And this time I didn't. And it really backfired on me. I took her to see the movie The Lovely Bones.
That's a laugh
riot. That was mistake
riot.
Number one. Where I was just at the time like, oh yeah, Peter Jackson. Like, he's a good director. Let's just go see this drama that he's doing. Oh my God.
Dead Kid the movie. Yeah, would that have worked better for
you? Stanley Tucci's running around being like a murderer, child molester person. Mark Wahlberg's really angry that he can't solve the murder. And the girls in heaven, I guess, running around being like, why can't you guys solve this fucking murder? And the whole time I'm just like, oh my God, this sucks. I'm really bringing the vibe down. Speaking of bringing people on movie dates, Colin, that was my move.
Let's not look at each other. Let's just look at the sadness.
Yeah, that we were looking at the sadness. I was like, wow, this is really going poorly. But little did I know it was going to go even more poorly. We were sitting in the theater. We were at Baxter Avenue Theaters.
Yeah.
And, it was the cool hip theater, Joey. I wasn't going to take her to Tinseltown.
Yeah, but how sticky were you when you left?
Oh, I was about to say sticky.
It wasn't worth it this time. So, there were people making noise in the theater a couple seats down from us.
Was it them boys?
No.
Hold on.
Nope.
Sweet 'em boys.
It was a group of African American kids, and they were making a lot of noise.
Ooh, the fact that you said that.
She.
Oh,
at one point, turns to me,
fuck,
and says, fully serious, "These fucking N words."
Oh.
And I sank in my seat. Very wide-eyed. I had no idea that that was going to come out of her mouth. And why would you say that to a stranger on a date?
That means it's even more normal to her than you think it is.
Yeah.
It's like,
we're all cool with this, right? Like, I can say this?
Yeah, every once in a while, a white person, drops that on me.
And,
I'm just like,
right? And it's like, no, wrong.
No,
why are you saying that?
No. No.
Get away from me.
I thought I knew you.
Yeah, exactly. I thought I wanted to have sex with you. Man.
What about my pizza pants made you think I was going to join in on this?
People need to think of a softer, this, using that word. Like, you might as well. So, but before I say this, what are your thoughts on the Civil War exactly?
Question to Blair before we started dating. What were your thoughts on the Civil War? Do you think that turned out right or what?
They just had to throw it out there. Man, I work construction. Happens all the time. Whether it's weird, sexism stuff.
Yeah.
Like, anyway, I'd totally have anal intercourse with her. I'm right?
It's like, she can hear us.
Right. Or it's something about
you
race.
You are talking to her,
And it's always, for some reason, it's always people who I don't normally interact with. It's not like the guys are like cozy up to you and like, anyway, let me tell you about my race stuff now.
Yeah. It's just tell you all my thoughts.
Hey, I just saw you. Anyway, don't you just hate brown people?
What?
No.
No, you're just delivering pipes. Get out of here. Or just
change
like,
your worldview, sir.
Yeah. Or, hey, I'm just dropping off this box. Anyway, I saw some females on the way over, and I would have sex with them. Let me tell you. Just like, what? Oh, am I supposed to respond?
Yeah.
Ugh. High
yeah,
five.
Yeah, man, that's icky, dude.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah,
so,
that's bad.
And she lived in Indiana, so it was a long, silent drive to drop her off. I was blown away. mostly that I had to sit through the rest of the Lovely Bones, knowing this is a sad movie. This is a sad date. This whole day has just turned out very poorly for me.
When you dropped her off, did you say something like, man, I thought we were going to Lovely Bone. Guess not.
I wish.
Anyway, you suck.
That wouldn't have been the worst thing said on that date.
No.
Yeah.
Well, she set the bar so low, he can then just experiment.
Right.
You know, he can just say
whatever. What are your thoughts on other things?
He can say whatever, and there's nothing to lose.
Yeah.
So you just throw out terrible jokes.
Yeah.
He can, just try new material like a fucking comedian.
It was on that day that I learned that hot girls can be racist, too. It's not just backwoods, hillbilly motherfuckers. It can be anybody.
Did she live in the backwoods?
Anyone can wear the
mask.
Very
nice neighborhood.
Oh.
So, yeah, that was... It would have been a bad date probably without the racism because we saw the Lovely Bones, but it was all of it together yeah. made it my top worst date.
But still, the Lovely Bones would have ended sooner or later. Her racism has no ending credits inside.
Right, it's true.
So.
Probably amplified.
Yep.
Did you talk to her afterwards? Was that
nope.
it? That yep. was just it.
It. Done. Nope. Don't need nice. To talk to her anymore. What do I have to talk to her about?
I know, but I didn't know if she reached out to you in any capacity. Or
I don't
anything.
Remember if she did
or
not.
Ran into each other. I guess not.
I probably wasn't a very good date after that because I really didn't say very much to her.
Yeah, I'm pretty yeah. sure she would have to be pretty naive not to pick up that, pick up on that.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I think I... What word did
hey,
I use?
Hey, you want to go out and be racist with me some more? No? What?
Was yeah. it the word loud? Motherfucker, what word was it? Some word. I don't know. We'll never know, I guess.
She was probably just like, I don't want to talk to that guy. He took me to see the Lovely Bone. She didn't learn her lesson at all. Yeah, so that's me. I set the bar for you guys. Who wants to follow that one?
I feel like I have a parallel story to that.
Okay.
Because mine involves judgment at the movie theaters that I don't think is on the same par as yours. Isn't I might be the bad guy?
Okay.
I've told you this story before, but it involves going to the movies with this girl. A bunch of my friends were talking. This was, I think I was in high school at the okay. time. I was hanging out with my buddies who were younger than me. I had mm-hmm. my license. They did not. So I had them in the palm of my hands.
Oh, you have to yeah. do what I want.
Slash, they would call me and say, what are you doing today? And I was like, oh,
we're friends with your car.
Hey, people older than me did it to me. You got to pass it on. You got to pass yeah. the vibes, you know?
Yep.
So I was talking to my buddies. We all ended up talking with these girls, kind of like a perfect 3-3 match. I was interested yeah. in a girl, and the other two guys were, you know, it all worked out. So we thought about going to the movies to hang out. We did not decide on a film until we got there, however.
I hate that. Why would you not decide on a film?
Because we were arguing
there.
About it, and you'll see why here in a second. Okay. Not much was happening in terms of like movies you want to see.
Right.
I recall seeing out of like the 5 movies we had available, because this is Paintsville, Kentucky, and it's small as fuck. So.
Gross.
Yeah.
Probably a lot of racists there.
Did you say Paintsville?
Paintsville. That's where I'm from. Is
wow.
it painting?
I've yeah. never heard that, and I've well, lived here my whole life.
Well, there's a lot of little towns in Kentucky that we don't fuck with.
I thought it's I knew most of here. The small yeah. counties.
No, it's in Johnson County. Anyway,
shut up.
Jeez,
no one knows what you're talking about.
I know that's where I'm from. I care. Anyway,
you belittle your hometown.
Hey,
somewhere.
They had a movie theater there.
You live in Indiana.
So you can go fuck yourself.
I was born in Louisville, born and raised, baby.
Anyway, so we were looking at the movie posters, and I was like, all right, so I guess Ice Age 2. That's what I thought was the best choice.
Wow. Okay.
I know,
so
right?
Ice Age 2 is the best choice.
Yeah, because you know the first one was fun. Now
I want some more Dennis Leary in my life.
That's now right. The Ray Romano, come on.
Yeah.
So the other person, the girl saw the movie, I think it was Larry the Cable Guy, Health Inspector.
Oh, nice.
So she was like, let's go see that movie.
Well, it
and
was Paintsville.
Yeah. I should have just
Larry
said
the
it was
Cable Guy probably had a 100% approval rating.
So I saw Ice Age 2 in Oxford, okay? Does this make the story any better now? No, it doesn't. So she saw that movie. She wanted to see that movie, which immediately for me is already like, oh, that's your stock
that
going
sucks.
Down.
Yeah,
you wanna see
she wanted to see that
Larry
movie,
the
Corey?
Cable Guy.
That means she was also racist.
Yeah, this is where I specifically disclaimed maybe not. But who knows, right? Who knows? There's still a question mark. And I said, let's not see that. I don't want to see that. To which she responded, oh, it's great. I already saw it. It's hilarious.
Oh, no.
Whoa.
Now her stock is just plummeting.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not only do you want to, but you already have and you want to see it again.
It was
we
bad
call those
money to you.
3 strikes, I guess, you know? Like,
she's going to spend money on it again.
Yeah.
I know. So eventually land on Ice Age 2. We go into the movie theater, and I am pretty obviously not as interested in this girl as I was 5 minutes
ago.
Mm-hmm. I didn't sit next to her,
oh,
which I feel bad about. And as soon as we left, I was like, all right, well, your face was here, and so is mine, and I'm going to go now. Like, we were both here at the same time. Good for you. Have a good day. And I feel to this day, I feel kind of bad about it, that I just sort of gave up on a person because she liked one movie. But what a doozy to pick, you know?
I don't even. I don't even think you're wrong, Corey.
The Cable Guy.
I can imagine now, like, oh my God, Witless Protection came out. Yay!
Right. Like,
you'd
have been
complete.
Stuck seeing all the Larry the Cable Guy
Delta
movies.
Farce, bring it on.
Probably right.
Making you watch the Bill Engvall show, and are you smarter than a 5th grader?
I had to like come up with plans to avoid, okay, Delta Force is coming out this Friday. What? Oh no, my house is on fire. Like, anything, just anything.
I bet that Paintsville exploded when the Blue Collar Comedy Tour came out for the first time. It probably was like, did. Yes, finally humor for us.
It's just a smoldering pit.
Yeah. I'm sad that we didn't talk about the Blue Collar Comedy Tour when Colby was here with us when we did our stand-up episode.
Yeah, you guys missed a big one.
Yeah.
It was such a huge thing, too. Yeah. Like, even if you don't like it, you have to acknowledge it.
Yeah, it was huge.
Anyway, for the record, I don't think she's racist. I just think she liked a movie
I didn't like, and her sense of humor was terrible.
She was pretty, very, very smart. Maybe I made a mistake. But then again, here I am. Enjoying
yeah, you wouldn't
my
be
time
doing
with
this
three
podcast with us.
Men.
Be like, Corey, get in here. We got to watch more Bill Engvall reruns.
I like the idea it would change me as a person if we saw Larry the Cable Guy that day. I would never come to Louisville.
Yeah, you wouldn't have been a lawyer. Right.
Exactly.
Corey's sitting in the other room just like, Ron White, Ron White. Please, Ron White. Please, Ron White. Please.
He walks
Bill
out
Bill Engvall's on. Fuck. He's the worst of them.
Corey walks out of the theater. He has overalls on and no shirt.
How did this happen?
Hey, you're one of us now. Let's go out.
Google gobble. Yeah.
And even she's like, what are you doing?
He's like, no, I'm fully in. I'm fully in. I'm 100% in on Larry
you
the Cable
commit,
Guy.
Are you fully in?
Yeah. Your stock dies because you commit and she's like, whoa. I'm going to be a lawyer. I just thought it was funny.
I just thought it was like a silly. I wanted to see it ironically with you. I thought we were going to make fun of it together.
Man.
She wanted to do a Mystery Science Theater 3000 with you, dude.
That's like if M. Night Shyamalan directed She's Out of My League. Like, so many leagues. Who's in what?
I love that movie.
I haven't seen it.
Rom-com trash. Give me that rom-com
Joey wants
trash.
Our rom-com trash. Joey wants our rom-com
I'd rather watch
trash.
That than Larry the Cable Guy or The Lovely Bones so
it's
far.
It's got
you win.
Jay, How to Train Your Dragon, can't pronounce his last name.
Baruchel.
Baruchel.
You just said Baruchel. It two different ways, and that's why I didn't say it.
Yeah.
And it's got Alice Eve in it.
Noise.
Super hot.
I think
she's
some of us
talented.
Would go on a date with her, probably.
Yeah. Unless she saw Larry the Cable Guy.
Yeah,
case,
unless she's
yeah.
a
I'm
big
out.
Fan of Lawrence the Cable Gentleman.
I would disappoint her in the movie theater for sure.
Yeah. All right, guys. Does anyone have a worst date that doesn't involve a movie?
Yeah.
Okay. Go,
nice,
Joey.
Nice.
It's just kind of like a sad,
oh,
like,
good. Oh, I want to be sad.
Well, okay. So this was with my first girlfriend in high school. And, you know, it was my first girlfriend, like,
nice.
Ever. And so it was just kind of like, I didn't really know how to do stuff. Like, one, didn't have a job, so no money. We were poor anyway. And then Valentine's Day was coming up. And
that's when you get out that construction paper.
I almost don't want to talk about this. So,
ooh, yes.
The plan was... I was going to go get her some flowers, then go pick her up, and then we go, like, have dinner.
Yeah, sounds nice.
And
Turns out you picked up dinner and took her to a flower store?
I almost don't want to talk about it. I wanted my mom to come with me to help pick out flowers.
Very cute.
Because I don't fucking... Okay. I don't
you're
care.
Right. No.
They're like, oh, these...
Nope, you're
people,
making it less cute, Joey.
People just... are like, flowers, they smell so good. It's just like, they smell like flowers is what they fucking smell like. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I don't know, like, whatever. I'm young.
You can pick them out wrong. Let me just
yes,
tell
absolutely.
You now.
Yeah,
there's
exactly.
Wrong
like,
flowers.
Exactly. It's just like, here's a fucking... I can't even name flowers because I don't care. But my mom was, like, running late, and I was just kind of, like, waiting and waiting. And she was dating this guy at the time, and he's just, you know, the worst person on the planet.
That dude sucked.
Don't even want to really go into it. But so they get back, and for some reason, me and him started to get into an argument.
Mm-hmm.
Probably because he's just like, he's one of those, I know best about everything forever, except I'm a dumbass. And so I end up getting mad. I punch a hole in my wall.
Mm-hmm.
I start crying, and then I just run out of the house and then just drive to my girlfriend's house. I show up crying.
No flowers.
No flowers. Upset, like, you know, busted hands.
Okay.
And then,
the pity angle,
and
I
then
like that.
It's just kind of like... And at this point, we had been dating for, like, months.
Yeah.
So it's one of those things of just, like... I don't really need to play the pity angle. We're kind of already, like, you know.
Right. We're
in
just
it.
Looking for support now.
Yeah. And then I just, like, it's pretty late. Don't know where to go. So I had a Valentine's Day dinner at Applebee's.
Nice.
Okay. There's the comedy.
Dave,
I was looking for it that whole time. It was very sad.
They've got a good spinach art.
What a punchline.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because, like, even like with that girlfriend, we didn't really go on dates because
right, you were young.
We were poor. you know, she was younger than me too, so mm-hmm. she didn't have a job, and we were just, it was just kind of like we hang out and then, you know, do stuff, you know, sometimes.
Right.
And yeah, but that was like a snapshot date that we were like, we're having a date. And then it was at Applebee's. I'm sure we got the 2 for $20 entree because I'm poor. And
get those appetizers.
I couldn't even tell you about the rest of the night because it was just so nothing.
Uh-huh.
Because it was just we went to Applebee's. Right. That's it.
Yeah.
It's like if I told you about my trip to Denny's 6 years ago with my friends, like it's same sort of thing, like no memory of it, just that leading up of just like, I'm going to try and make this special. And then it was just this crash and burn mm-hmm. with me just sadly just failing.
I have a fun memory of you and that girlfriend of yours, Joey.
Yeah.
Well, yes. Okay, so we were at my dad's house.
I knew he was going to bring that
Nick
up.
Nick was at the Applebee's.
Yeah. I was watching, and I was like, oh, Joey, you failed so hard. I was there to root for you. Right. Turns out I was rooting against you.
He dropped that racist girl off, and he was just lost, and so he went to Applebee's.
Guys, good news. She didn't turn out to be racist. She did turn out to be crazy.
Okay.
All right.
Well, yeah, because she couldn't read a room, so we were at my dad's house for Christmas.
I thought you were about to say read or write.
She couldn't read a book. No, it's not that bad. She, like, we were all just, like, sitting around talking. It was Christmas time, and Joey and her are on the couch, and she's, like, all over Joey, like, laying on his lap, putting her legs up on him and stuff, and it was just...
Yeah.
It was just a thing that you could tell that they were just really young because they couldn't read a room and they liked each other, and she liked Joey a lot.
Yeah, I don't...
But it was just so uncomfortable.
I just remember her sitting on my lap at one point.
Yeah.
But then you made a note... You, like, mentioned it to me, and I was just like, yeah, I didn't realize that that was, like, uncouth.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, Joey, can I give you a note real fast?
A dating note real quick? Hey, bro. Our family's here. Please stop.
I didn't see it as inappropriate. I just thought she was sitting on my lap. But apparently Nick was glaring at us. And
well, it wasn't just me. It was the rest of the family.
Grandma's crying right now. Can you stop the things that you're doing? Please.
Yeah. I mean, it's all good, Joey. Our grandfather didn't want me and my long-term girlfriend, who turned into my wife, to stay in the same room when we were at their house.
That was a whole thing.
Yeah, I was like, I've been dating her for like 6 years. Right. Can I just, and, like, do you not know that we live together?
And you're like, remember that time Joey was like fucking in front of everybody?
Different grandparents, but still the same.
Gotcha.
But yeah, so that was just a...
Well, let me tell you, and then you can get mad at Joey.
Oh, you think this is bad? I'm an adult.
Right. Deflect.
All right, the last person to tell us about their worst date is our friend Colin Sage.
All right.
I thought this was going to be fun, but everyone's just really sad.
I'm actually not sad at all. I did think this is a great premise for comedy, right? Funny, bad dates, ha-ha. And I was like, all right, surely I have some of those. And I started to
think. Turns out they were all the best dates.
That's right. All my dates were perfect. No, I started to think back, and it was just like, well... Like, I don't have any, like, oh, the waiter, and then he tripped on a banana, and then he fell, and then we watched Lovely Bones. No, so basically, I have had plenty of bad dates, but they're usually, like, you know, because of, like, a toxic relationship's ending, so it's just, like, screaming or something, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Hot.
Yeah, which isn't funny, so, and nor is it really like a bad date scenario. It's just a bad relationship scenario.
It's a bad time.
Right, it's just a bad time all around. So, I've got a different kind of bad date story.
Okay.
I got a play date, a date with my boys.
Oh, okay.
All right? Me and my, this was probably about high school,
mm-hmm.
maybe right after. Me and my boys decided to go on a date. We went to Gaddyland.
Okay.
We went to the same Gaddyland that you all snuck into as children.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Yes. And so around the time, we were playing high school football, and we had this thing we called group poop. And you would all...
Sounds cool already. Sounds very cool.
This sucks.
Right?
Sounds like some high school boy shit.
I knew Joey would be upset. All right, let's talk about my colon some more. So anyway, the point of the story is we're in Gaddyland.
Mm-hmm.
We each like, all right, group poop because we just ate like 20 pounds of pizza.
Yeah.
We want some more because we're poor, mm-hmm. and we're going to fill up. So we're sitting, we all take a stall, and then we're all talking to each other.
High-fiving
like,
under the stalls?
No.
Those are low fives, Joey.
You know, there's like, somebody's like, Pat, ooh, yeah, oh, this is actually bad now that I think about it. One guy passed nudes a girl sent him.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Mm, yeah, that was uncomfortable then.
Like
but
a
like
Polaroid it, under the stall?
No, it was like a flip phone, and it was like, hey, this girl I'm talking to just like sent me a picture of her ass
ooh,
or something.
Ooh, damn pixels.
Yeah, but damn now pixels. I'm thinking back, that's pixels. Gross.
It is gross. We can all acknowledge that.
Yeah. We can acknowledge that it was gross. It was, yeah, I never, anyway. Anyway, so we're all talking, we're having a good time, we're all taking a shit, whatever. Somebody breaks out a bouncy ball they won in Gaddyland.
Gross.
Are we talking about a little bouncy ball?
It's pretty, it's not tiny,
baseball
but it's not
size?
Big. No, it's not baseball size. It's like golf ball size.
Sure.
It's maybe
okay,
a little bigger. And we're bouncing it between the stalls.
Right. Man, right? This is classic dude fun.
Right, yeah, and it's just stupid high school dude fun, and we're bouncing it. Anyway, it bounces into my stall, mm-hmm, and then it hits the ground and rolls out onto the floor, mm-hmm, like over by the sinks.
Okay.
And so your boy's just like, fuck it, I'm going for it, boys. Open up the
and the principal of Gaddyland was there. Mr. Gaddy himself.
Mr. Gaddy with his deck of Uno cards. It was bad.
In a webcam.
Yep.
Yeah.
He hit me with that reverse card. then he took his pants down.
Yeah.
Anyway, I open up the stall door. I waddle out.
Nice.
Pants around ankles.
Sure.
Everything is around the ankles. Go to pick up said bouncy ball. It's on the floor. I'm kind of by the sinks.
Mm-hmm.
If you boys remember that
bathroom. I know this bathroom very well.
Yep.
Anyway, I reach down. I'm totally bent over. Reach down. As my hand clasps around the ball, the door swings open, and a adult man and his like 5-year-old son walk in, and he's like, "All right, Timmy, here we go. We're gonna like teach you how to use the potty."
No.
And I turn, but I'm still bent over. My asshole is facing them.
Yeah,
great.
They can see it. The kid, however, doesn't see it. He's oblivious. He's like, oh, Gaddyland or whatever. But I watched the dad in the smoothest motion I've ever seen. He doesn't even take a beat. He's just like, all right, Timmy, we're going to use the bathroom. Nope, actually, we're going back outside. And he just, it was so smooth. Like, it was rehearsed. He was just like, in? Yep, here we go. And Timmy was like still looking at. He wasn't paying attention.
Yeah.
And the dad just hits my eyes for this second as I'm holding the ball in my hand and looking up at him, and he's looking at me and my asshole and just everything, and he just goes, all right, no, actually, we're going back outside. Oh, Timmy, what's this out here? And just, like, steers the kid back out.
Timmy still lives in his dumb, naive world.
Yep.
I was kind of hoping and dreading that it was going to be something out of, like, let's say, a Larry the Cable Guy movie, where the dad, like, screams, and then so you scream and you flex, and then you shit, like, on the kid, and it's just, like, comedy ensues.
Man, get my brother
jokes
in a writer's room with Larry.
I do have a story about shit in a bathroom. I'll tell you if you want.
No.
No.
Please,
no.
Not me. Anyway.
Don't care.
Worse?
Anyway, it ended up being a great date. Later, I consumed an entire cinnamon pizza, vomited it up in the parking lot, and then consumed about half more of another pizza.
Nice, dude.
I took a couple pizzas out the door.
So many things you explain. Like, hey, man,
no
just,
wonder
just a bunch
went
of
out
boys
of
having fun. I've never encountered it in my life.
Let's go to Gaddy's.
Corey, you need to go with us.
No,
let's head over to we're just four boys
come on,
going
to Gaddyland.
I'm already have anxiety enough, like pooping in public restrooms and stuff, but doing it with your boys.
We can all take
and
a shit
plus,
together.
We're playing a game. I got to keep this bouncing ball going.
Yeah.
Dude, there's too much going on right now.
Dude, when you're young, you just want to spend all your time with your boys, even in the bathroom.
We were just having fun. It was that time where you've had your first job, so you got money, mm-hmm, and you're ready to go out and hit the town, but you go to Gaddyland because you're 17.
Yep.
See, also another thing, knock this clock back by at least 5 years, like 12, if you're a 12-year-old, maybe.
Okay. No,
how you get into Gaddyland?
Right, yeah.
17,
You gotta go when you're 17. That's the first chance you have money, and you want to relive some of your fun youth, but you're kind of saying you're doing it ironically, but really you're actually enjoying it.
Yeah,
that's exactly what that is.
The first time I went, like, back to Gaddyland when I was, like, 16 or whatever, since we had kicked open like arcade machines yeah. and gotten tickets in nefarious other ways, I went back there with some boys.
Obviously. Nice.
And I still had my fucking Gaddyland card
yep.
from when I was a kid, and I had like 15, maybe like 20,000 tickets on it.
Finally got that wow. yoga.
And I was
all.
A fucking king.
Yeah, you were.
Whoa. You were
now,
like, bouncy
I
balls
flopped
for
that mother. Bouncy balls. Bitch, I got a Nerf gun.
Whoa.
I got like a Nerf gun. I got, but then I was just like, all right, let's get goofy. I got all those Tutti Frutti's.
Yep.
Like okay. two sacks full of Tutti
yeah,
Frutti's.
Fill up these sacks, sir.
Vampire teeth.
For days. The whole crew was vampires that day.
Like whoa. Finger sweatbands yep. that had like yin yang symbols on them.
All right. I like that. Take me back to the early
2000s. The shittiest little trinkets that China could make.
Probably a ping pong paddle, you know what I mean? Like, I was a god at yeah. Gaddyland.
All the kids were super jelly of my brother.
I probably
day.
Should have asked out, like, the cashier.
Yeah,
like,
you
know, just
yeah.
like, it's like throwing down the black card.
Yeah.
You know, where, like, a credit card.
You ask her on yeah. a date, she's gotcha. Like, whatever. And then you, like, hit your card in the scanner, and she looks at it, and she's like, oh my god.
15,000, huh?
Oh, man, this dude is fucking sexy.
I'm gonna get that boombox, and then we're going to the Lovely Bones.
We're gonna go take a group poop.
Where's your bouncy ball?
What's up? Hey, group poop, it was a great thing.
Yep.
All right, here's my other poop story. Here I go.
I don't want Please you to. No. Let me stay on topic, Colin. I got another bad date for you guys.
Hey, it involves a movie theater. It involves a public restroom.
I don't care.
All right.
Putting a stop to your bullshit. My other worst date, it's not worst, but it was a bad date. The time that I proposed to my wife.
Oh, sick. I haven't heard this story.
Okay.
I also sucked at that, but go ahead.
Yeah. So, me and Blair had been together for a long time. We had moved to Chicago and come back. I was trying to save money to buy an engagement ring. And my wife was wondering why I wasn't proposing when it was really like I was just trying. I didn't want to like open a new credit card to get a ring for her.
Yeah.
So I stashed cash for a while and she's getting really fed up with me not proposing to her. And I really wasn't afraid of commitment. I was just really trying to stack that cash. Mm-hmm.
And then she
which
found
I did.
The cash and was just like, Nick, you're a drug dealer, aren't you? And then you've been selling blue meth.
What's it matter if I'm going to get you this baller jewelry?
Nice.
So we went on a date, and it was we kind of knew it was going to be a special date. She'd been asking me to take her on a nice date for a while.
Take me on a proposal date.
Right. Yeah, that's basically the subtext. Because she knew that I had bought the engagement ring because one of my other friends really dropped the ball when I bought it.
Call him out. Call him out.
No, it wasn't a he. It was a she. It
Call
was
her
Taylor.
Out.
Taylor Campbell. She.
What's her address, Nick?
She.
Give me that social.
We were at. I had bought the ring on the day of another friend's wedding. And I had to take it to the reception.
Did you buy it from Taylor?
No.
Like after
your boy
the ceremony,
went to Jerry.
She walks out in her wedding dress to the parking lot. She's like, all right, you got it.
No, it's kind of confusing, but I ridden with my friend Patrick, who she is the wife of. And I left my bag, which had the Jared bag, in his car.
Mm.
So they were leaving before us. So I said, hey, Taylor, can you take my bag and throw it in my car for me? It's got my engagement ring in it. Please put it in the back and zip the bag up so she doesn't see it. So we get out, me and Blair, at the end of the night. I open the back door. I throw something in, and I see my bag sitting open. With the freaking Jared bag sticking out. My wife also sees it. We make eye contact, and then we silently get in the car and drive home. Because my first thought was like, all right, fuck it. I guess I'm just going to propose here, whatever. Ugh. But I didn't do that. And so I waited like 5 more months. I just sat on it. I sat on it.
Holy shit.
Oh. I went the opposite direction.
Yeah, you auto-corrected a bit too
so
much.
My wife really was waiting for a proposal date. So we went out and we got sushi at our favorite sushi restaurant. That's fancy number one.
Was it Sapporo's?
Oishi.
Actually also going to say, was it Sapporo?
No. We like that place, but we went to Oishi.
Both places are good.
Yeah. Then we walked around the town a little bit, Bardstown Road, went to shops and stuff, had
how
a nice time together.
How many vacuum cleaners you buy?
Two. Two tornado sharks.
How's that place in business?
Two out of six vacuum stores.
Then we went to the place where we had our first date, which was Dairy Castle. You guys know Dairy Castle.
Yeah.
It's a great little ice cream place. You walk up and order.
How can
you? And then we went home, and I didn't propose to her. And so when we were going home, Blair was very, very mad at me.
I remember all this.
She didn't know that I had set up the proposal at our house. It was in the bedroom, which we closed because we had our dogs. I didn't want the dogs to get in and like eat the ring. So we get home, and I'm like, oh, what do you want to do? You want to watch Straight Outta Compton? Like, what's going on? And she was so mad the whole time. And finally, I was like, hey, will you grab a blanket out of the bedroom for us? Bedroom.
Right.
And
then
I was
she
gonna,
left.
I was going to film it. I was going to film it, but she'd already, like, gotten in her comfy clothes. So I was like, okay, put the phone away. So she opened the door, and, you know, all the things were there. And I proposed to her that way, but she's so mad at me. I was just like, yeah. She's like, what, are we just going home? And I was like, yep, just going home. And I felt the anger hitting me in my face.
In like, the form I don't even know if I want to propose anymore.
Yeah, it was... We're not the kind of people. I'm not going to propose like a ball game, you know, like put us up on the Jumbotron.
Yeah.
No, I was going to do it privately.
I feel that you want it to be this big thing, but then you also don't want it to be this cheesy big thing. And then there's this weird expectation, and you're like, no one's going to tell me how to do it. I'm going to do it my way. But then you kind of talk yourself into this weird corner where you're like, I have to do it my way, but it can't be special, but it needs to be special, but it, fuck. And then
I took like 8 hours to carve a hole in a Harry Potter book, gang.
Wow.
I had to carve a square into a book, like hollow it out.
My favorite Harry Potter book, no!
I bought a special one. I didn't just like destroy her Harry Potter book.
Blair, which out of the seven, which one do you hate the most? Like just, you know.
Did you take the cover out and like Photoshop your face onto it?
I wish.
Whoa,
Nick Potter
and the prisoner of
this
matrimony. Yeah,
you call it Blairy Potter and
Blairy Potter and the prisoner of this matrimony,
prisoner of marriage.
Nice. Yeah. Yeah,
she pulls out the ring and it like is. She's like, "Oh, this is great!" And then it's like attached to like a chain. And she's like, "What?" She starts pulling up, and then it's like these iron links.
Yep.
And you're like, "Oh, I made those myself. Pretty hot. Cool, huh?"
Oh man, it was. If I ever, I was like, "Well, I guess I'm never hiding anything in a book." This is. Imagine if I wanted to hide a gun in one of these books, that would take me all fucking day.
I've definitely tried that. Hollowing out a book takes a long time. Yeah, it's not very precise,
guys. Neither. You just got to stab it with a basilisk fang.
Oh, you're right.
What the.
Harry,
you're right.
Fucking
Harry
Potter,
right? Idiot.
You're right.
Fuck you.
I said you were right.
Fuck you.
What are you doing later, Joey? You need to.
You
want to
watch
shit,
the Lovely
take
Bones?
Take shit or something. We got some bouncy balls. We'll get this relationship.
We can go to the bathroom together and all watch Lovely Bones on our phone simultaneously. Those guys have been taking up all the stalls for about the length of a Peter Jackson movie. What is going on?
And I keep hearing them cry silently. It's sort of sad.
But the bouncy ball is still going?
Is Mark Wahlberg in that bathroom?
They're still passing nudes under the stalls? They didn't even wash their hands.
I'm on chat roulette.
Just committing crimes in bathrooms with my boys.
Yo, bro, those guys aren't playing Uno. Watch out. You get on chat roulette, bro, they're not playing Uno. They're playing
Also, my daughter solved this mystery.
I think the chat roulette killed my daughter, bro.
Can we take a bones and, like, reverse card him back to life?
No,
Is
you.
Is that how that works?
What? No.
Yo, I think the plants killed my daughter, bro. I don't know.
I got a wild card. Is that going to bring some evidence up or something? I mean, that's pretty good.
Uno dos tres. I'm learning.
Plus four more charges. That's good. We're going to get this bastard.
Stanley Tucci, you're going down, bro.
Is your spot on Mark Wahlberg impression.
I love it.
Yo, it's just a New Jersey. It's not good, but it's something.
Man, when
hey,
you
go to Wahlburgers.
When you first said Lovely Bones, I was like, oh, did you mention that you almost dated Jennifer Lawrence or something because you went to middle school with her? And then I was like, wait, that's Winter's Bone.
Yeah, that's Winter's Bone.
Equally sad.
Yeah. Another small story that doesn't have anything to do with anything. I did go to middle school with Jennifer Lawrence.
And that was the worst date you ever had.
I wish. I wish I would. My wife is like, why didn't you lock her down in middle school, idiot?
Because I was like, then I would
sorry, as you were getting bullied.
Yeah, as I was getting bullied.
Did she say that to you when you proposed to her?
Yeah. Yeah, this is great, but you really should have locked down J-Law.
You should have been proposing to J-Law right now, you idiot.
Why didn't you carve out a DVD copy of X-Men First Class?
Whoa.
Yeah, she was on the cheerleading team, I believe.
I don't know. No, crazy.
Anyway, her parents took her out of school because they had money and believed their child. That, like, imagine any of you that you walked up to your dad, Colin.
Yeah. Three theater degrees.
Right, but seriously, like, Colin, if you walked up to your dad when you were, like, I don't know, 10, 11, you were like, Dad, I want to be an actor. Can we go to New York? Your dad would have, like, smacked you in the face.
Pull me out of school.
Yeah, pull me out of school.
Give me a private tutor and then private acting lessons and then just take me to New York for the address, I guess.
Yeah, for,
and
like,
then
years, let me do this.
Yeah.
Man, what a dream.
And you know what's crazy? It really pissed me off. People asked her about that. They're like, do you think more people should do that? And she was like, oh, absolutely. And I was like, oh, fuck you.
Fuck you.
Yeah, like, oh, no, you got incredibly lucky. You had parents that had money and believed that their 11-year-old could be an actress. Like, yeah, she is, and she's a good one, but, like, how many other people do that and fail miserably? You know what I mean? Like, don't encourage people to ask their moms to move to fucking New York. I that's so unrealistic.
It's called a second mortgage, okay? It's not a big deal.
Yeah. My mom would have told 11-year-old me to go fuck myself.
You can be in Winter's Bone too.
That could be you. Has anybody here seen Dark Phoenix?
Yeah.
No. Jennifer Lawrence topic?
No.
Oh my God. God, does she not want to be in that movie?
And she isn't, but for like the 14 minutes she super doesn't want to be there.
She talks about leaving in the context of her character.
Yeah, she's
even.
Like, I want to leave. Me, Mystique. Wink. CGI. I'm not interested in this X-Men bullshit anymore.
Right. I am tired of being painted blue.
They had to CG her eyes up off of her phone.
They CG'd her phone out and her eyes upward towards other actors.
I thought that mustache was bad, but this is even worse.
Her eyes are so dead in this movie. And they really were, man. She could not have given a flying fuck.
Yeah. Mm.
Man, that's when you know you made it. Is
yep.
You're just doing movies that you hate for money.
I'm just making money.
Yeah, all those little new X-Men's are trying real hard. They're like, we're not super famous yet, please.
All those X-Men are like, Mom, can I move to New York and be in the X-Men movie?
No, idiot. Get back to mowing the lawn. We're poor.
Where's your fucking lemonade stand at? Cyclops. Oh.
Damn.
Dumbass.
Oh, anyway, that's just an interesting thing. Cammer Middle School, J-Law, me and you, baby girl. Yeah.
Hashtag don't forget.
You're about to have too much lawnmower in your blood.
No one believed me until I started running around with my yearbook, and I was like, there she is! Damn. There she is! It's like,
who are you?
Oh, wait, is that what happened on your date with your wife?
Yeah.
We went to sushi, and I
pulled out my yearbook and said, there she is, you were wrong.
I carved a hole into my yearbook.
She saw the Jared's box, but right behind it was my middle school yearbook in my bag.
I could have been something!
One day.
One day I will
One
be.
Day.
One day me and J-Law will get together.
Oh, just take out a second mortgage.
Okay.
You now have a daughter.
Yes.
Take her up to New York.
If she comes at me at 11 and is like, I want to be an actress, I would laugh in her face.
No, dude,
tell her to go fuck herself.
You're already too late. You needed to get her on YouTube 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
For sure.
You can get her on TikTok now.
No, I think that'll be dead by the time she's old enough to use it. There'll be a new one.
Yeah.
RIP Vine. I miss you so much. TikTok is nothing compared to you.
Sometimes I go to Nick's house and we just watch old Vines.
I make him do it. I'm just like, these are funny, right? You remember get trapped, 2013?
Man. You get fucking trapped and you're like a 30-minute Vine compilation. I'll just like... I'll check out around 7 minutes, and then you're three Vine compilations.
Yeah, you're three deep. Yeah.
And your night is over.
Yeah.
I got to find out what happens next. Nothing happens next. What do you... Get
it. Well, I'm supposed to go on a date, but I just watched Vine.
Our date was watching these Vine compilations, and if she didn't laugh at the ones I liked, I told her, get the fuck
right out.
Right,
and then you look over to your computer webcam, and you're like, hey, did you enjoy this date, watching Vines with me over this?
Oh no, I'm turned to stone!
Anyway.
I should have not fallen for
what
that.
What a Shyamalan twist.
Here's a draw two card, and here comes my pizza pants.
All right, that was fun slash depressing slash fun again slash Colin and his boys.
They still got the 2-for-20 entree at Applebee's, guys. Check it out.
They still got it. It's still just as sad as it was 15 years ago.
You get an entree.
I'm pretty sure they tore down
all
the Applebee's.
They got half-price appetizers, dog, after like 10 o'clock.
Yeah, dog.
Get their sponsors, Applebee's. I'll take that money.
I don't know if there's one
There's
left.
A fucking Applebee's
in
Clarksville.
City?
Yes.
Well...
This in Indiana, all yeah. right, that's a different
the bar's
place.
Lower here. Louisville's more.
There's at least three in southern Indiana, which is like half the size of Louisville.
Yeah.
Right, but they got rid of all the ones in Louisville. And, like, they just migrated.
We banished them to southern Indiana.
How many Chili's you got, though? Because they're the same.
None. They're gone.
Oh, they're gone too?
I thought we still had that Chili's on
I don't know,
Goss
but you know what
something.
This isn't? It's not interesting for people to listen
yeah,
to. So let's do the wrap-up, please.
Right, let's head to Outback Steakhouse.
Mm. Mm.
It's very mediocre.
The way of the chains is the past, man. All right? We're all looking for organic farmer's market food now.
Exactly. Mm. The franchise is your home on Grubhub or whatever horseshit people do nowadays.
I'm trying to kill a cow with my bare hands and cut them up and eat it.
And
right?
then take it to Outback Steakhouse where they prepare it for you poorly.
Exactly.
They're going to overcharge you.
Wow, you ruined this.
They're going to find a way to get the corporation's hands
and
all
these
over
onion
that.
Bloomers you gave me while I was waiting are cold. Stone cold.
I don't think they've ever been cooked.
Just gave me an onion.
There's still there is still earth on this.
Why
onion.
Is there a Y in this onion word on this box?
Fuck it. We're going to Waffle House, boy. Yep. My boys are going to Waffle House. There we're gonna go. Have a group poop.
There's only
it's happening.
Yeah,
those are
single stalls.
Yeah.
Hey man, just four boys hanging in a close
we're
quarters.
We're gonna
bathroom.
Have a group poop. Okay.
Non-negotiable.
You get over that shit right now.
Yep.
All right, in 2 weeks from now, we're going to have Worst Dates Part 2, and it's going to be our shared group poop.
Yeah, for sure. All right, guys, thank you so much for listening to this episode of Very Real Talk. Corey, thank you for coming on again and talking with us, man.
Hey, thanks for having me on to share my embarrassing story.
Of course. I want to know how petty you are when it comes to people's personality and humor choices.
I wonder if I can see like all the topics you have listed, if it's embarrassing. He's going to ask me to be on that one. God damn it.
Hey, I enjoy...
Well, we don't plan that far ahead.
I enjoy that you enjoyed Ice Age 2, you know? Yep.
It was okay. Yeah, okay. That was the point of the story. It was okay. Yeah. That's why I told that story.
Yeah.
The meltdown. I'm not sure which one it was. I don't
who
fucking
knows?
Care.
It
was the one
who knows? Who
Queen
cares?
Latifah, I think, was.
If you want to hear us talk about more bullshit, please head over to our website. That's vrtcast.com. You'll find all of our episodes there. You'll also find the other podcast we do. That's called Very Real Tournament. We are the four hosts of that. We are in season 4, baby.
Sure. We're also in peak physical condition.
Yes.
For that podcast.
Absolutely. We stay cut. We stay fit. And we stay funny. So all of our stuff's there. If you want to tell us about your worst date and how you accidentally dated a racist person, hit us up at our email. That's vrtcast@gmail.com. If you send us that, we'll read it on air, man. I want some fan mail. I want some shared experiences with you guys. So please send it there. If you don't want to send it there, you can hit us up on our social media. Very Real Podcast. We're on Facebook. We're on Instagram. We are on Twitter. We are not on Chat Roulette. We are not on TikTok. And Vine isn't a thing anymore.
Mm.
So, also, we're on all the podcast apps. Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Stitcher. Are we on iHeartRadio? I think so.
Maybe not that one, but
okay.
We are on
Spotify.
Spotify.
We out there. Check us out. Share us with your friends, your family. We're just here to have a good time and here to make sure you all have a good time.
We are on Chat Roulette. Just keep hitting that button. You will find us.
Colin is on Chat Roulette.
Look for the pizza pants.
Look for the group poop.
Oh, no.
And before we go, shout out to the Thumps for making the music for this podcast. You can find them at their Bandcamp, thethumps.bandcamp.com, or, you know, check out their Facebook to see where they're playing shows, or just, you know, find them on all the streaming services.
Yeah, man, they're a great band. We love them. They produce very good music, including the song for this podcast. It's called A Lot On My Mind. They made it especially for us. We love them very much. Shout out to you guys. All right, now let's get out of here, okay? I'm Nick Potter.
I'm Joey Potter.
Colin Sage.
Corey Music.
It's been real. It's been fun. It's been a group poop.